Welcome back to our channel, guys. Do you have one of these solar floodlights? Do you have trouble understanding the remote? Well, let's talk about that today. In this video, we'll be doing a quick demonstration on the various types of remote control for solar floodlights. Let's get straight into the video, guys. Solar powered floodlights comes with various types of remote control depending on the brand that you buy and depending on the technology that is used to design the solar remote control. So we have various type. That's one. This is another type and another type right there. And we also have this type. This one here basically controls this light. Wow, it's very bright. Okay, since we're not dealing with the light today, we are dealing with the remote control. Let's get straight into the remote control demonstration. So we have here four different types of remote control. You might identify the remote control that your light uses by looking at these right here. So how these work, they're all has the same functionality, but they might work differently for different floodlights or street lights, solar lights. So on this remote, you have auto. On all four remotes, there's the auto key. Auto basically mean when you turn it on, it will stay on until the next morning and it will automatically turns on at night. So you don't have to be turning it on every night and turn it off in the morning because you already set it to auto, right? You also have the on button. So the first time you're going to use this light, you press the word on. Not only this light but other solar floodlights, you press the word on and it will automatically turn on once the light is fully charged or has charge in it, it will automatically turn on. And you press the word off to turn off the floodlight. These numbers on the side right here, if you look closely, you see 3 hours, H mean hours. So 3 hours. So when you press 3 hours, the light will be on for 3 hours. It will automatically turn off after 3 hours. 5 hours, the same thing. 8 hours, the same thing. Once you press that button, it will turn off within 8 hours. So if you see the light goes out and you were playing with the remote before, just turn it back on and it will automatically stay on. Or you can press auto and it will automatically stay on for the rest of the night and the next day. So the first time you install your light and you press auto, you don't have to be using the remote daily. So these two buttons right here, you see a half moon here and a full moon here. This means the light is on full. You can press this one with the half moon to turn it, to adjust the brightness. So once you press it, the light will actually turn down. So it will be getting lower and lower and lower, as you can see right there. Right. If you want it to get back bright, you press back full. And it will automatically adjust. You keep pressing it until it goes back into full bright mode. So that's it for this remote. And this one here is basically the same thing as a on button. You press to turn on the light the first time you're going to use it or to turn it off. This on button is also act like a auto button. So once you press it the first time, the light will automatically stay on and come on the next day as well. But you have a special auto button down here as well that you can use to press it for it to automatically work every day. So you see where you have the 2H and 4H. These mean that if you press it, the light will stay on for 2 hours. If you press this button here, it will stay on for 4 hours. And these button right here is to adjust the brightness of the light. So you can turn it up or you can turn it down. Likewise, this type of remote control, that's the auto button. Once you press the auto button, it will automatically turns on at night and automatically turns off in the day. So you don't have to turn it on and off every day. The same thing with H. The 3H mean 3 hours, 5H, 5 hours, 8H mean 8 hours. So the light will stay on for this number of hours and automatically shut off when it reaches this amount of hours. And this is the buttons that you use to adjust. Where you see the sun? This sun here mean full. So once you press it, you get the full light. If you want it to be halfway, if you want to save battery life, you can adjust the brightness of the light using this button. Same thing for this remote control as well. Auto mean it will automatically turns on at night and turn off in the morning. 3 hours, 5 hours, and 8 hours, meaning that these are the number of hours that the light can stay on for if you press this button. But if you press auto, you will get it for 12 hours. So it will operate in a dusk to dawn mode. And you can turn it on using the on button and off using the off button. These two buttons right here is to turn it up, turn up the brightness of the light. And this one is to turn down the brightness of the light. Remember, if you're looking at a replacement remote control for your solar floodlight, you have to bear in mind the type of light that you are using and the technology that it uses. Because not because all of these have the same functionality doesn't mean it have the same type of sensor that would pick up from the solar light. So in the solar light right here, there, this black thing right here is a sensor. So different companies uses different technology for their solar lights. So you have to ensure that the remote control that you're replacing it with is the actual one that will allow you to operate the solar light. Thanks for watching, guys. Please to like, share, and subscribe this to our YouTube channel. And please also share this video and other videos on our channel with other persons. Thanks for watching.